Hello, and welcome to section 4.3. In the section 4.1 notes, I say the following. To find local extrema, we should therefore find critical values and somehow check whether they're local extrema or not. But we'll put that discussion off until section 4.3. Well, that's now. We will learn the first derivative test for classifying local extrema.